Well, right around 1996, President Bill Clinton named General Barry McCaffrey to be the nation's drug czar. And, you understand, McCaffrey's a man with two distinguished service crosses. He'd just been catching drug smugglers from South America, so the newspapers all said, "How are a bunch of hippies and stoners gonna take on Barry McCaffrey?" Well, they found out.
It was the biggest coke binge anyone in central Michigan had ever seen. 9 young men, a bachelor party, 17 pounds of Peruvian blow, and 2 connected rooms at a Holiday Inn Express near the airport in Lansing. They got so high for so long that they missed the wedding, instead turning up 5 days later in California at a Warner Brothers production lot where they successfully pitched a sitcom about a toy poodle that teaches at Harvard. It lasted 3 seasons.
McCaffrey was being flanked in Hollywood, so he sent Alan Levitt out there because everyone always said Levitt could implant anti-drug messages into literally everything. So Levitt goes to Hollywood, and all of a sudden, every drug user on NYPD Blue gains 40 pounds.
My dearest General McCaffrey, so far, I have managed to insert anti-drug messages into a Magnum P.I. episode, 3 local weather reports, and the architectural blueprints for a new branch of Citibank. I have also received word that drug abuser Chris Farley is eventually supposed to grow old and mature into a respected dramatic actor. I've scheduled a lunch with the head of his studio and hope to arrange for different results. Yours warmly, Alan Levitt.
Meanwhile, Kenneth Blatter in Martinez, California, got so good at smoking pot he could leave his body and travel directly into the sun. The Union was losing.
My dearest Annabelle, I'm so high right now. I'm so high. Have I actually seen things out loud? We're all getting slurpees. Yours beloved, Kenneth.
Then General McCaffrey got word 7 people in East Orange, New Jersey had had pleasant acid trips. Well, that was the last straw.
General McCaffrey sent 100 agents into East Orange with one instruction. Harsh. Everybody's buzz.
They'd hang around the corner, singing off key, insulting people's hair, really aggressively trying to sell auto insurance. It devastated the whole town.
They tricked him. Those teenagers in East Orange, they had all swore off hallucinogens, because what they really wanted to do the whole time was OxyContin.
Next week on The Drug War, the government finds out coffee is a drug, and everyone dies.